Hey there, Fit Fam. Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, whatever time of day it is for you. Hope you're having a great day thus far. So today is our Monday workout, our leg day workout that we have for you. And it's going to be a traditional Tabata-style four-station workout that we do pretty often here at Plates on Plates Fitness. So we got that going for us, right? So you I'm sure in the description of this video, you clicked on the link and you saw exactly what we're doing today. So we'll kind of talk about that a little bit more as we get into the day with everything on the video. But for right now, we have got to do a warm up. We've got to warm up so we can work out and be efficient with our workout, obviously, right? Well, we all know that. Our warm-ups consist of a 5-minute AMRAP style, meaning as many rounds as possible. I'll put the warm-up and stuff right here for you. These 5 different exercises that we have, you're just going to cycle through from top to bottom. Start from the top again, just kind of work your way through until the 5-minute time cap is up. It's kind of the way that it works with that. So as you're actually doing the warm-up, I'll keep this over here so you can reference it at any time. As I'm demonstrating the exercises for you, I'll put them right back down here at the bottom of your screen for your convenience. Same thing will happen whenever we talk about the workout. I'll have the whole entire thing sitting over here for you when we get to that point. As I demonstrate, I'll put the exercises over here, and as we actually go through the rounds, I'll put each round over here on the bottom right-hand corner of your screen as well. So make things a little bit easier for you as you go through. And the timer, of course, will be right here in the middle. Can't go wrong with that. So let's work on this warm-up real quick. So we have jumping jacks, toe touches, plank to a down dog, Cossack squats total for this one, and high knees. So, starting from the top, jumping jacks. Shouldn't need much of an introduction to you. Probably done them 1,007 times, but just for giggles, getting that full range of motion here with your arms. So we just don't want to do like this. Really open up those shoulders, get a good jump, keep that core engaged on those. Next is going to be toe touches, and I will kind of leave this one up to you how you want to attack these toe touches, okay? You can either A, standing up, I'll show you from the side, you still want a soft knee, we don't want to be here with our knees pushing back and hyperextending those knees or anything. Want a soft knee, I just want to bend down, keep my back as flat as I can, and get as close to touching my toes as I can with a soft knee and a flat back. Again, I don't want to be here and really rounding my back over to touch. I want to make sure I get a good stretch in my hamstrings. Back to the top. You can do the exact same thing in a seated position with your feet straight out in front of you. Here, a back again, nice and tall. We just want to come out and get close to touching our toes. Or if you're super good, you can go past there. Just try not to do this, right? I don't want to round it back. I want everything nice and straight. Good hamstring stretch on that. Now, while I'm down here, plank to a down dog. So, starting off in a high plank position here, back nice and flat. I'm just gonna push it back, get a good stretch in my shoulders, and back to the high plank. You can kind of do your heels up and down, get a good stretch in those calves as well, and just keep going back and forth there. Kind of make it your own on that one. 5 of those. 10 Cossack squats. So Cossack squat is it can be a little rough, but we want to start off nice and wide here. Okay? So we're going to start off on one side, go Go to the other side. Back up. And then you can just, that's gonna be five per side on that, 10 total. So if you're gonna go from one side to the other side, back and up, that's times like two. Okay, make sense? So you want it nice and wide, you wanna get low in that, and then switch sides and back to the top. Pretty simple with that. Try and get as low as you can. You don't want to be here and then start doing like this, right? We don't want to push our hips back into it. We want to be low with those hips. Nice and low here, not here. So if your back is almost parallel with the floor, you got way too much hip hinge on that. That back should be upright here. Cool? You got this. And then your high knees. That's a high knee. That's a jog in place. What are we doing? High knees. Exactly. There you go. So there's your 5 minute AMRAP warm up. I am gonna go set a timer. I will get some tunes cranking for you. You get your bottle of water next to you, whatever else you need, and I'll meet you back here in a few minutes. Actually, a few seconds. Actually, almost like immediately. But for me, it's gonna be around. Anywho, I'll meet you back here in a few minutes. Alrighty, Fifth Fam, I am back. We got about 15 seconds before we start this 5 minute full-blown AMRAP style warm-up. 20 jumping jacks, 10 toe touches, 5 planks to a down dog, 10 cosmic squats, and 20 high knees. And go. This is your time to shine. Do it. Let's go. Crank up the intensity. Jumping jacks, toe touches, plank to a down dog, cosmic squats, and high knees. Stretch in those toe touches and those down dogs. Get nice and low in those cosmic squats, right? High knees, get that heart rate up a little bit. Jumping jacks, the same thing. Don't skip on those. They're just as important as the other stuff. Halfway, you are exactly halfway through the warm up. Time's gonna fly today, I promise y'all. The workout is gonna go by pretty quick too. With the standard Tabata, 40 seconds of work, 20 seconds of rest. It doesn't take much for just to fly by. Really cool exercises today. couple of new ones that I think you're gonna dig for sure. Some challenging things added today. We have 90 seconds. 90 seconds. You should probably be at least 3, maybe 4 rounds in. Somewhere around there, I'm thinking. Yeah. One minute. And then we'll talk about the workout. We'll chat a little bit. Well, I'll chat. You'll listen. Unless you don't want to listen, then you can pause. But if you pause and don't listen, you may not know. Just don't do that. You gotta see the words coming out of my mouth. Less than 30 seconds, my friends, working all the way to the last beat. Because it's going to be the same way in the workout, working to the last beat, right? All right, y'all, less than 10 seconds. Keep moving. It's not stop time yet. Keep going. All right. And relax. Let me turn this down. Don't go anywhere, because I'm just going to just go right there and come right back. All right. See, I promise. I'll be right back. All right. So the workout for today, like I said, is going to be 4 stations. Okay? Each station over here has got 2 exercises per station, okay? 40 seconds of work, 20 seconds of rest. Each exercise is done 4 times. And then we'll take 1 minute of rest and go into station 2. 4 times each, station 2, 1 minute of rest, station 3, and so forth, okay? So 40 seconds of solid work, 20 seconds of rest to transition into the next exercise, okay? So we're gonna work from beep to beep. Start to finish, right? The 20 seconds is just there to give you enough to kind of catch your breath to move to the next one, right? We'll have plenty of rest when we get done. It's only, what, like 8-minute stations? And, you know, 2/3 of that is actually working. So you got to remember, it's not a solid 8-minute work. You still got a little bit of rest in there. So think about it like that. All right, so we'll start off here with number 1, the extended plank hold. You're probably like, what in the world is that? So let me show you. And there's going to be different, like, I wouldn't say variations of it, but there's going to be levels of difficulty that you want to achieve with this, okay? So an extended plank hold is that instead of having our hands underneath our shoulders for the plank, we're going to push our hands out a little bit further, right? So we're a little bit closer to the ground, and we're going to put a little bit more pressure on those shoulders, engage those lats, going to engage those shoulders, engage your pecs. Everything's going to be engaged. The key to this one is squeezing your butt cheeks to really maintain that really tight control over your core. Okay? So, starting off, let's just say I am here in my normal high plank position. Well, I'm going to walk my hands out to about here and staying in that plank position. I can go out further if I feel comfortable going out further, maybe not quite as far, right? But somewhere in this general vicinity is where you want to be. And if you're shaking like me, you're doing good. Squeeze that butt, keep that core engaged, and that's what you're going to do for the full 40 seconds. Really easy, just kind of gauge how difficult you want this to be with your hands going out. Now again, just because my hands are out in front of me here doesn't mean I'm going to go wide with my hands. I still want my hands right at shoulder width like I would on a regular plank. So don't make the mistake of going out here in front of you and trying to go like really, really wide with this. Keep those hands here. All right, that's the key to it. You got to keep those hands in front of you and keep them shoulder width apart. Next is going to be a one arm thruster. Kettlebell, dumbbell, whatever you have. Can't really use the bar for this if you have a bar because you're going to go one arm per round. So I'm going to show you with a dumbbell. Make things just a little bit easier. So let's start. I'm going to start with my right arm on this round. I'm going to clean the dumbbell up. Remember, a thruster is a squat into a push press in one movement, right? So I'm gonna squat, up, push press. As soon as it comes down and touches my shoulder, that's my turn to squat. Just like so. Really, when you get to the top there, use everything you have to really push that dumbbell up in the air. Now, the other hand that's not working needs to be out somewhere in space, not on your hip. So we don't want to get the habit of this. Here, out here somewhere. You want your core to take over for stability. You don't want to have artificial stability with the hand anchored to your body, because that's what's going to give you, all right? Station number two, we're going to use a dumbbell or a kettlebell again. This time, we're going to do a plank pass-through. So, I'm going to start off with the dumbbell on one side of me, here. Back here a little more, you can see better. On one side, I'm going to get into a high plank position here. I'm going to go with the opposite. So, if it's on my right side over here, I'm going to cruise over with my left hand and pull the dumbbell over. So I'm pulling it underneath my body while maintaining that high plank. Keeping my back flat. If your feet are a little bit wide, that's okay. Adjust the width to maintain that stability, okay? Because you don't want to get in the habit of doing like and being all loose. You want to maintain that structural integrity, keeping those shoulders nice and flat to the floor while you're pulling that dumbbell or kettlebell underneath of you. Okay? Next, on station number two, it's going to be sprinters. We're going to work one leg per round. So sprinters, if you can imagine, you're sprinting like here, right? Using those hands as you sprint, we're gonna do the same thing, just from a reverse lunge and up, okay? So let's say I'm starting with my right foot coming back, left leg to be planted. So I have my right. So from the side, here. And being quick with it, but still keeping that chest upright. Don't droop, keep that core engaged. Station number three, seated pike pulse. Two options for this. You're still gonna be the same seated position, doesn't matter. Either lifting both legs or one leg at a time. So I'm here in a seated position, like so. I want my hands kind of out in front of me a little bit, okay? So right probably around between your mid-thigh to the knee is where you want your hands. You don't want to be over here or back like this. You just want to be nice upright, put your hands out kind of where they're gonna fall. I like to have my fingertips touching the floor, not the palm of my hand. Here, I feel like I'm a little more upright and I can do a little bit better. Once I have this, I'm gonna use my hands for stability. I'm just gonna raise my feet up. bracing my core every time. So really deep breath. Brace that core. Option two. One leg at a time. Okay? Now with these, it can be a little bit funky. Take your time with it. Brace that core. Really feel what you got going on there. Okay? This is all about feel. Bracing the core is so huge on that one. Okay? Kettlebell, dumbbell, front squat. Two different ways you can do this. Again, I'll show you with a dumbbell. And you can do a pair, singles, whatever. If you want to do with a pair of dumbbells, here front rack, where I've got the dumbbell head sitting on my shoulder, hands right underneath, elbows a little high. I just don't want them down low. I want them up enough where it keeps the dumbbells on my shoulders. A little bit wider stance than a normal squat. Deep breath, soft knee, hips back. Knees out, up. Now you can read my shirt every time. That's what you want to see, okay? We can do a single. We can just switch every round. Or we can do goblet style here. Any of them is perfectly coolio with me and should be with you. All right, last station. One arm plank leg lifts. Right. Those are going to be a little rough. So options. I'll show you the option of the leg lifts, of course. Option to do without the lifts will be just to hold a one arm plank. Okay, so this one's gonna be a little difficult. It's really gonna challenge your core, but try and keep under control as much as possible. A little bit of body roll is probably gonna be inevitable, so don't worry too much about that. So we're gonna have, starting off with a high plank, you're gonna just one arm per round. Okay, so let's just say I'm gonna start off with my left arm on the floor, right hand out in front of me, plank. I'm going to raise first the opposite, and then that. Okay? Make sense? You're just going to raise each leg. Take your time with it. Once you do a handful of them, you'll be good. It's just going to take a little bit of coordination to let go and to disperse. Not really disperse, but to make a transition with your core and what's gonna be active. Activate those glutes. Make sure that you're really getting in tune with it. Push through the shoulder, don't be low. If you're just gonna do a one arm plank hold, wide with your feet, out here somewhere with your hand, keeping the shoulders nice and flat with the floor. Right, like so. And then jump lunges, that's the last thing. All we're gonna do in the jump lunge is there, alternating back and forth, keeping the chest upright every single time. Boom, boom. All right, so get your dumbbell, your kettlebell, whatever you want with the exercises, and get it together. I'm gonna go switch this over, crank up the tunes, and I'll meet you back here in just a few seconds. All right, Fit Fam, I am back. You should be ready to get this cranked up. You got about 12 seconds before we start the workout. I'll put up here just for a split second. And then station number one will be right down here in front of you. Extended plank holds, that is first. 40 seconds worth of extended plank holds. Work your way a little bit further every time. Okay, so continue to challenge yourself through this particular exercise. Brace that core, squeeze those glutes. Okay? Work your way out a little bit. Make sure though, again, your hands, when they go out in front of you, are staying at shoulder width. not out like this. That defeats the whole purpose of everything. This is where you want to be. Alright, 20 seconds of rest, and then your thrusters. One arm thrusters. Pick an arm to start with, pick a side, and you're gonna do that side for the whole 40 seconds. As many reps as you can in that 40 seconds, starting now. Thrusters, dumbbell, kettlebell, whatever you have for weight with one arm, one hand, one side at a time. We'll switch to the next side on the next round. Keep on going with those thrusters. Do not stop. All right, rest. Back to the plank hold. Alright y'all, let's do it. Extended plank hold, top of round two. Alright y'all, we got about 10 seconds left in the plank hold. Squeeze those abs, brace those abs, squeeze those butt cheeks. Rest. Switch arms on the thruster for this round. We started on the right arm. Left arm gets a love this round. Challenging right now. If you're not shaking through this, you're not out far enough. Seriously. You better be challenging yourself on these guys. It's an awesome, awesome exercise. Challenge that core and rest. Thrusters coming up. Opposite hand of last round or the same hand you started with on the first round. Bottom of round three. So stinking close, y'all. So close. Come on. Pick up the pace. You got a minute of rest coming up here in just a little bit. Get as much work in as you can. All right, keep working. You got 5, 4, 3. Keep going. 2, 1. Rest. Last of the extended plank holds coming up. You're going to want to do these again and again, I promise. All right, y'all. Top of round 4, extended plank hold. Let's do it. This should be it. This should be held out as far as you can to maintain that structural integrity of that core. Squeeze those glutes. Shake it out. It's going to shake a little bit. Hold it as long as you can. You can do it. Come on. Have faith in you. 100% faith. There we go. Keep going. And rest. Last of the thrusters coming up. All right, y'all, this is it. This is the final 40 seconds of this round. You got a minute of rest coming up. The station's almost over, right? Then you got some plank pass-throughs and sprinters. So a little bit different stuff on the next round. Myself, so I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Oh, y'all, we have 20 seconds before we start station number 2. So, I'll put station number 2 right down here for you. You have your plank pass-throughs, right? We're gonna start on whatever side. We're gonna grab it and pull it through to the other side. Maintaining that core integrity, keeping that back flat, squeezing those glutes. You need to go just a little bit wider with your feet, that's cool. Just maintain that stability, keeping those shoulders nice and parallel with the floor. All right, so don't let yourself sag through and I'll start twisting. Keep that core engaged so you're not twisting, work against that. Keep working. And rest. Now you got sprinters. Remember on those, we're going to work one leg per round. Starting off here. Here we go. Sprinters. Get a good push off that plant foot back there. Right? Take it nice and high up in the air. Top of round 2. whether it's dumbbell, kettlebell, whatever you have for weight, go from one side, drag to the other. That's what you want to use. It can be anything that has some weight to it. No hard or fast rule for it. In a sprinter.
Sprinters it is.
Last of them, take them all the way to the final beat. Don't stop early. Come on, challenge yourself. That's why you watch these videos, because you want to challenge, you want to work out, you want to stay active. We'll make the very best of it. Make 100% of it. Come on, 10 more seconds. You got this, come on. All right, 1 minute of rest. Get ready for the pike ups and the front squats next. Okay, the seated pike pulses. Oh, y'all, less than 30 seconds, and it's go time again. You're halfway through the workout, by the way. Dude, I know, right? These will go by really quick in the last ones. So, seated pike pulls, and your dumbbell or kettlebell front squats. Whichever one you want to use, it could be, like I said, the goblet style, front rack, whatever on that. Pike pulses, remember those? Two legs or one leg, alternating, whatever you want to do, just keep that back flat. Make sure you got a good brace in front of you and brace that core. Don't round over. And no, you cannot do regular pike ups in lieu of the seated pike pulses. Two totally different things. That's why scaling is one leg at a time as versus two. You want to challenge yourself and not just give up with it. Keep going, y'all. 5 seconds. All right. Front squats coming up. Now, if you do have a bar and you want to do a bar work front squat, you can do that. Only a few. Just keep that chest up. Really make sure that you keep those elbows up too, if you're in that front rack. Seconds, y'all. Get those last squats in. One more. Come on. And rest. Back to the seated pike pulses. Again, the seated pike pulse, the only scale would be one leg instead of both at the same time. So if you just do regular pike ups or you get in and out, yeah, you're going to get some good work in. Don't get me wrong. But you're not going to challenge your core the way it's meant to be challenged in this particular exercise, okay? So remember those things whenever you want to scale something, if you're still challenging the same way that you would. That makes sense? We don't want to totally just swap out a new exercise unless there's some sort of a physical reason that we need to, then we can. Less than 10 seconds. All right. Rest. Back into front squats. Alright, front squats, bottom of round two, station number three.
Come on,
Rest. Seated pike pulses, you know, that's next. You should get the hang of them by now. You know exactly what's going on, you know how to make sure that you can get them done correctly. Keeping that core engaged and braced the whole time. Trying to lean back. You want to keep that chest as upright as you can. Y'all, 10 seconds. In this context, there's no disrespect. So when I bust my keep going. Alright, rest. Dumbbell or kettlebell front squats or bar front squats. That's what's next on the menu here. Got 10 seconds to think about that. Get ready for it. As soon as that last beep hits here, you're gonna crank it up. Now, front squats, bust them out. Take it to the last round of the front squats. Alright. Awesome job, y'all. Keep up the good work. Keep it going. Last of the seated pike pulses. Second, y'all, can last few in. Come on. Alright. Last of the front squats. Coming up. Got 10 seconds. Keep that chest upright. You don't want to be down here in that front squat. Sink straight down into that. Got that counterweight in front of you. Right, it's gonna change your center of gravity a little bit. We're gonna dig down nice and deep in that squat. Station is coming up. You take a break. You get some rest. I'm gonna grab some water. Right back. Alrighty, y'all, we got about 20 seconds right now for your one-arm plank leg lifts, okay? One-arm plank leg lifts and your jump lunges. Remember on those one-arm plank leg lifts, you go a little bit wider with your feet, and you may tweak a little bit. Feel it out. make sure you push through that shoulder though of the plant hand. Okay, push through, brace the core. It's gonna take maybe a round or so to kind of get an idea of where you're at. Now, if that's just not working without you losing just everything, then just do a one-arm plank hold. Just make sure the arm that's not working is somewhere out in front of you, okay? Alright, and rest. Jump lunges. That is alternating jump lunges. Keeping that chest upright. Starting here. I just don't want to say that. Be purposeful with your movements. If it's slow, it's slow. I'd rather be purposeful with it than try and go fast and being out of control. Time with it, feel it out. And rest. Bottom of round two coming up. Jump lunges. Station number four, by the way. In case you're not, what's going on? Last station, bottom of the second round. Good. Straight up, chest upright, and you're just swapping feet. That's what you want, a blast off, right? We want to make sure we get way up there and swap legs. It's all about being powerful and explosive with these movements. You want those fast twitch muscles to work for you too, right? Halfway. Keep going. Rest. All right, last of the plank leg lifts coming up, the very last of them. All right, here we go.
I wanted the fame, but not the cover of Newsweek. Oh well, yes, Vegas can't be choosy. Wanted to receive attention from my music.
All right, y'all, just 10 more seconds, y'all. Come on. Pop them out. Let's do it. Work all the way to the end.
Cause my ego inflated when I'm Brucey, but it was confusing. Cause all I wanted to do was be the Bruce Lee, a Bruce Lee, a Bruce Lee.
All right, rest. Last exercise of the last station, of the last round, of the last part of the workout for today. This one is it. This is for all the marbles. This is the one you should go, all the way to the end and bust it out. No excuses. Go, 40 seconds. Just take these guys to the cleaners, y'all. Let's do it. Don't skip, though, on good posture, good quality. All right, y'all, halfway, let's go. You got this. Keep moving, keep pushing. Yeah, crack up when I say something like that. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Awesome job. Hey, let me turn this down, and then we'll go into the finisher. One sec. Oh yeah, so as you probably know, May is our 1 minute air squat challenge finisher, right? Quality air squats is what we're looking for. And when I say quality, I want those hips down past the knees. I want to make sure those knees go out over those toes. I want to keep that chest up, those shoulders back, and I want to lead with my hips. I don't want to lead with my shoulders. It's not a hip hinge. You're dropping those hips down, okay? You're squatting, not hinging. So we're not doing good mornings. We're doing squats. Squat being here as opposed to here. Hips are still really high. I want my hips down low and my chest upright. There. That's what we want for some quality squats. Are you up for it? You ready for it? Okay. I'm going to set a timer, 1 minute, crank up some tunes, and then we'll get started with it. So hang tight just for one sec. All right, y'all, 15 seconds. Squats coming up. Start to finish. 5, 4, 3. Good. Air squats. Squat it out. Quality over quantity, that's what it should always be. I promise you, once you have the quality and the efficiency with these squats, the quantity will go up. It has to. 20 seconds. Come on, y'all. Come on. Get those last reps in. Quality reps. All right. All right, y'all. As always, awesome job today for the workout. I hope you enjoyed it. A good leg day workout for dang sure. So, this is going to be one of the last the YouTube videos that we're going to put out moving forward for a little while. We're scheduled to open back up on May 18th. That's going to be on Monday. Okay, so I won't have everything set up to do our workouts like this. We will have a live stream option. So if you're a member of Plates on Plates Fitness, there is a live stream option for you if you're not coming in here to hang out with us when we open back up. But that's how we're gonna play it out. If I can keep doing these YouTube videos and everything for you, I absolutely will. I've just gotta get some stuff figured out as far as how I'm gonna actually do it. But we can figure something out if need be, okay? But I've enjoyed hanging out with y'all this past, oh my God, probably 8 weeks or so that we've done these. So there's a ton of content on YouTube for you. So if you just stumble across us here, or you've been here many, many times, there's a lot of things out there you can do. It doesn't hurt to do the same workouts maybe once or twice for it, right? It's still a good workout. You can mix and match, do what you want to do. Maybe, you know, go up in reps. There's a lot of cool things that you can work on with these videos. But anyway, so that's it. That's all I got to say about that. You know, I really appreciate everything y'all doing, stopping by here. And until we meet again, hopefully I'll see you soon. Make it a great day because only you can. Love you guys. Bye.